Hi friends, today let us see the relations. Before that we have already completed the sets, classical sets and fuzzy sets. Now we need to see the relations. So first we need to see crisp relations or classical relations. I want to separate these crisp relations into two videos as it may come some bigger syllabus. So let us first concentrate on crisp relations under video 1. So let us see what we have to study exactly under the relations. The topics to be learned are crisp relations. In this video let us discuss only Cartesian product and cardinality of the crisp relations, and in the other video we will see the operations on crisp relations, properties on crisp relations and the composition. So the operations and properties are maybe approximately same as the classical sets, but the composition is something different. Here we need to learn separately. And coming to, these are under crisp relations, and let us move to fuzzy relations. So fuzzy relations are also exactly same as the crisp relations. As we know the difference between the classical sets and the fuzzy sets. Here also there is a small difference between crisp relations and the fuzzy relations. Okay, let us go through all these differences and we will study these two separately. And here the other topics are the tolerance and equivalence of relations. So these things are very important, and these relations are also different for crisp and also fuzzy. So we need to study crisp tolerance and equivalence relation and fuzzy tolerance and equivalence relations. So as per my knowledge is concerned, I can cover within two videos for crisp relations and one video for fuzzy relations and one video for tolerance and equivalence relations. So obviously I like to take around 4 to 5 videos for these relations. Let us see if it completed within those videos, that is also well and good. Okay, let us see the Cartesian product and what are the crisp relations and what is the cardinality of the crisp relations. First, before going to that, I want to explain the difference between classical relations and fuzzy relations, or crisp relations and fuzzy relations. So as we know, there are only 2 degrees of relationships in crisp relations. One is a relation, completely related or not related, only 2 things, just like our sets, whether it is coming under the set, whether it belongs to set or it doesn't belong to set. Just like that only. Here completely related or not related, only 2 things. And coming to fuzzy relations, there is a infinite number of degrees of relationships, maybe from 0 to 1, whether it is completely related and not related and in between them. That's the difference. Anyhow, let us discuss one by one. First, the Cartesian product. So if an ordered sequence of R elements are written like this, and for crisp sets A1 to AR, the set of all R tuplets, these are called R tuplets. And if the sets, each element is related to one set, for example, there are R elements small A1 to small AR, and there are R crisp sets capital A1 to capital AR, such that the small A1 belongs to capital A1. That means the element small A1 belongs to the set capital A1, and element small A2 belongs to the set capital A2, and so on. The element small AR belongs to capital AR, then it is called the Cartesian product. Then the Cartesian product of capital A1 to capital AR is denoted like this, capital A1 cross capital A2 cross capital A3 cross and so on capital AR. This is not the arithmetical product. Okay, this is represented like this. Let us see how exactly the product will be. Okay, yeah, the Cartesian product of two or more sets is not the same thing as the arithmetic product of two or more sets. Okay, this point is very, very important. This is not exactly the arithmetic product. Not exactly means it's not at all equal to the arithmetic product. And this product, Cartesian product, is different and arithmetic product is different. Okay, let us see one example so that we can come to know. Yeah, when all sets are same, when all sets are same and equal to capital A, then the Cartesian product is capital A power R. Okay, just like arithmetic product, but that is different and this is different. This is represented like that only. Okay, this is only the representation, but the exact things are something definitely different, completely different. Okay, let us see all those things. Okay, don't worry for them. And let us see the notations for this. The Cartesian product of two universes, let us take only two universes. One is capital X and capital Y, and they are denoted like this. Then capital X cross capital Y is just like a Cartesian, just like a coordinate system, small x and small y. And let us define the small x and small y. The small x belongs to capital X and small y belongs to capital Y. That means the Cartesian product, if the Cartesian product is also a set, then each element of this set have two things. If it is a Cartesian product of two sets, then each element is having two things. One thing is from this set one and the second thing is from the set two. So this thing is definitely the element of the sets. Okay, the first element belongs to the first set and the second element belongs to second set. Combinedly it will become one more set, and this is the relation, Cartesian product. Okay, and this is the formula. Let us go through with an example. Okay, don't worry about that, just understand this. So the strength of this relationship between the ordered pairs of elements in each universe is measured by the characteristic function. Okay, yes, we have already discussed this thing also. Characteristics function X, and that will be like this. If it is belongs to capital X cross Y, that element, then the relation is 1. If it doesn't belong, then the relation is 0. Simple. Okay, nothing to worry, it's very easy. These two are the notations, and let's go ahead with the problem. The elements in the two sets A and B, two sets are given, and the two elements in set A is 0 and 1, and three elements in set B are A, B and C. Now let us find the Cartesian products of these two sets. First, let us find A cross B. Yes, A cross B. So as we have already discussed the formula, A cross B means one element from A, so I have taken 0, and one element from B, I have taken A. Then it will be one element in this relation, A cross B. So that element is 0, A. Simply. Next, the first element from A and the second element from B has been taken. So that comes the other element in the relation, Cartesian relation A cross B. So that element is 0, B. Similarly, 0, C and 1, A, 1, B, 1, C. Simple. Okay, this is the Cartesian product of two sets A and B. Now let us see what is the Cartesian product of the other thing, B cross A. See, this is B cross A. B cross A means everything is reversed and these two are not at all equal. Okay, that we have to see. This is not at all an arithmetic product. Okay, now here same thing happens. First we need to take the first element should be from B and the second element should be from A. So the first element of B is A, and the second one element from first element from A is 0. So the first element in this Cartesian product is A, 0. The second element is obviously A, 1, B, 0, B, 1, C, 0, and C, 1. So these are the elements in B cross A. And as we have already discussed, if the two sets are same, then it will be A cross A, and it will be called as A square. Simple. Yeah, as we know, we have already discussed it's just a representation. So one element from A and one element from B has, one element from A and the one element from A has to come and has to form an element, and that will be the element of Cartesian product. So see here, 0, 0, next 0, 1, and 1, 0, and 1, 1. Please take A as two different sets and try to make it up. Okay, then it will be very easy. And let us see the other thing, B cross B. It is B square. So you can see A, A, B, A, C, B, A, B, 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 C, C, A, C, B, and C, C. It's very easy. So please try to understand this. This is very important thing. Cartesian product. Okay. Next. Now let us go ahead with crisp relations. So the crisp relations means the relation is a subset of Cartesian product. Okay, there are so many Cartesian products. Let us, yes, let us see if, for example, I want to take a relationship from A cross B, and I can take the relation 0, A, 0, C, and 1, B. That is a relation. That means that relationship should be a subset of Cartesian product. Okay, that is called crisp relations. So the relation is a subset of the Cartesian product. Okay, A1 cross A2 or whatever may be the sets. Okay, that is, that doesn't matter. And this subset is the full Cartesian product, is called a binary relationship from A1 into A2. So suppose the subset is full, complete, one, how many elements are there in the Cartesian product, and those many elements are there in the subset, I mean this relation, then that is called binary relation. Okay, if the same thing, if 3, 4 or 5 sets are involved in the subset of full Cartesian products, for example, three elements are involved, then that is called ternary. Okay, ternary relationship. And if four things are involved, then four sets are involved, then that is called quaternary. And if five sets are involved, that is called quinary, quinary relation. Okay, if two sets are there, that is called binary relation, and that should be the complete full Cartesian product. Okay, now that is this, that's the thing. Next, what is meant by relational matrix and Sagittal diagram? Relational matrix means, yeah, when the universes are finite, the relation can be conveniently represented by a matrix called relational matrix. So how the elements are related, that will be represented as a matrix. Okay, that will be seen in the next slide. And the strength of the relationship is the unconstrained case, is given as Sagittal diagram, that can be explained here by using problems. Okay, let us see these two problems. See, there are two sets X and Y, and the relationship matrix and Sagittal diagrams are shown like this. See, it's a matrix, and 1, 2, 3 are left side, that means X elements, and ABC are on top, and okay, that is on from Y, and the all are related, so definitely it has been given 1, and the figure has been shown like this. So this is for Sagittal diagram, and this is the complete explanation of classical relations or crisp relations. If you like this video, please like it and share with your friends.